Welcome to our video tutorial Bionics4Education. Today we want to talk about the elephant's trunk and its usage in robotic. In the picture you see an industrial robot used today. This kind of robot is fast, is heavy, is very accurate and so dangerous for human beings. Therefore, these kind of robots work behind fences and a lot of safety equipment, making sure that no human gets in contact with this robot while it's working. So therefore, engineers are looking for ways to let robots collaborate with human beings. And this type of robots is called collaborative robots or cobots. Usually this is done by means of sensorics. So sensorics supervise the position of the robot in relation to the human being. And if the robot comes near to the human being, the speed and the forces are reduced. This means you need a lot of sensorics and therefore a complicated system. Bionic engineers were looking for role models in nature to solve this problem and found it in the elephant. The elephant's trunk is a kind of natural robot, but soft and flexible and therefore inherently safe for human beings. The elephant moves its trunk with a lot of muscles and can extend the trunk, shorten the trunk and also bend it. Festo engineers copied the elephant's trunk and created the Bionic Handling Assistant. In the Bionic Handling Assistant, we have three segments and each segment consists of three chambers. And every chamber can be air pressurized and so in this way extended. And depending on which chamber is air pressurized, the trunk bends or extends or shortens. Altogether, the Bionic Handling Assistant has 9 degrees of freedom. In the Bionics Kit, we have three bio-inspired robots and one of these models is a simplified model of the Bionic Handling Assistant. And this is what we are going to build now. So let's see what we need. So first of all, we need these plastic discs. We need the main body with the controller. We need again the middle part. We need the top part and the servo holder. We need these foam springs, all 12 of them. We need the cable ties. We need the two little fin ray grippers. And we need all four servo motors. And finally, we need this pneumatic tube, this blue one. One thing I forgot, and this is these little two springs we need for the gripper. Before we start with the assembly, I want to tell you that we have on our homepage a detailed assembly instruction under bionics4education.com. You can download it free of charge and you find a step-by-step introduction how to assemble the Bionic Elephant. So there are many ways to start the assembly of the Bionic Elephant and I would like to start with the drive unit. For this we need these servo carrier, this part, and three servos, the bigger ones. So we have, as you may know, a smaller and three bigger servos. We take the bigger ones and put the smaller on the side. And then we assemble the servos like this with the help of a cable tie. So put the cable tie around it, close it, and tight it. And if you don't like it, you can cut away the rest of the cable tie. Okay, then we can put this on the side. For the next step, we need the gripper. And now we want to form the body of the trunk. And for this we need the foam springs and these discs. These are forming the body of the trunk and with the cable ties we have, so to say, the muscles which are actuated by the servo motors. So first of all we put through these holes the three cable ties and then we string first a disc on the cable ties. And we use always the outer hole. Next, we use the soft part and string it too on the cable tie. Like this. And this process we continue with the next disc, and step by step we form the complete trunk. So here we have now a complete body of the elephant's trunk. To finalize the assembly of the trunk, we need to install this blue pneumatic tube in the center of the trunk. It serves as a kind of backbone. We have to push it through the holes inside the discs. And then finally put it in the hole, which is in the center of the gripper part. So the next step is to connect the body of the bionic trunk with the drive unit. For this, I put this on the side, and then I take my drive unit, and then the easiest way to do it is to connect it step by step with the servos by using a lock of a cable tie. You can cut off. Wrong direction. So here's the next one. So, last step of this is to put the tube also in the hole of the drive unit. And then we have a stiff backbone for the whole thing, and now you can adjust the cable ties, the locks, so that the whole thing has a certain tension. Like this. Okay. Then we can cut the cable ties again to the length we need. So the next step is the assembly of the gripper. And for this, first of all, we have to install the little springs I forgot a minute ago. For this, you put the springs on this little pin you see here, so that they are guided, and on the other side too. And so we have a little preload for the gripping jaws. Here's the other one. This makes sure that the gripper opens again if it releases the force. And then we install the gripping jaws, in this case also a fin ray gripper. So why do we use fin rays as gripping jaws? The reason is because a fin ray can adapt to parts you grasp. And so you can grip different shaped things at the same time with the same gripper. And if you want to have a try with this, you can try this with a paper fin ray you can download from our homepage, Bionics4Education. You can make this fin ray here made from paper, but working exactly the same way like the real one. To actuate the gripper, we need again cable ties. And first of all, we need one long cable tie here in the center of the body. Put a little bit down. And then another one across to that. We fiddle here through the little holes. Put it through the other cable tie. And we fix this with another lock. So in this way we can open and close the gripper with the help of the cable tie. The last servo is installed on the middle part, like this. Again with a cable tie. Now we connect the little servo with the main body by putting it together and fasten it. Then I connect the cable tie, actuating the gripper with the servo motor, like this, and fasten it with another lock. Okay, so now the mechanical assembly is nearly ready. Last step is we have to bring in the cables through the holes here in the top part into the inside so that we can connect it with the controller. So the last step is to connect the servo motors with the controller. But before we do that, we have to put in the batteries. So usual Mignon batteries, you can use batteries or accumulators as you wish. Then connect the cables and make sure that the black cable is put on the pin with the label black. Switch on the controller. So now we put the controller inside the housing. Make sure that the cable do not interfere with the lever of the motor. Connect it, and I think now we are good to go. Now we connect it. So first we connect to the network, to the controller, and this is B4E with some cryptic numbers. Click on it, then there's a password required, which is education. And then we are connected with the network. So then we open the browser and type in www.b4e.com. And then the control panel opens, but we have to choose Elephant. Then we see four sliders, and with the sliders I can move the elephant. First we close and open the gripper, like this, with the servo in the inside, and the other servos bend the trunk to their direction. As you remember, our goal was to create a soft and compliant robot which is safe to interact with human beings. And as you can see, our bionic handling assistant is very soft and can't hurt anybody. So, goal fulfilled. If you like this video and our bio-inspired robots, please visit our homepage, bionics4education.com, and find more information. Goodbye, and thank you for your attention.